Hey guys, what's up? Action here, back with a new gaming PC build. And today, magbibuild ako ng worth 60,000 budget gaming PC featuring all MSI components. As usual, i-introduce ko sa inyo isa-isa yung mga parts at habang ini-introduce ko, i-build ko na din siya. Tapos, I'll show you some benchmarks later para may idea kayo about the performance of this build. So stay tuned in this video for that. First of all is our CPU, which is yung Intel Core i5-11500. It is a 6-core, 12-thread CPU with a base clock speed of 2.7 GHz and a turbo boost clock speed of up to 4.6 GHz. Of course, may internal GPU na din ito, which is yung Intel UHD Graphics 750. But we'll be using a discrete GPU for this build naman. May stock cooler na din, pero kung gusto nyo maka-extract ng more performance at may iwasan natin yung thermal throttling from your CPU, we can use an aftermarket cooler for that. If ever naman na medyo tight ang budget nyo, you can also get either the Core i5-10400F and yung 11400F or even the Core i5-10500. Speaking of CPU coolers, we have here one of MSI's new liquid AIO coolers, which is yung MagCore Liquid 280R. Simply, it has a 280mm radiator along with a 240mm ARGB fans, which are silent as MSI claims, and it is compatible with MSI's Mystic Lite. It can also support a wide variety of CPU sockets and platforms. So goods ito in the long run. So ito yung magandang feature nito guys, is yung rotatable blackhead. So pwede nyo ma-rotate up to 270 degrees. So no problem sa black when it comes to orientation na magkakaroon kayo ng awkward positioning yung logo ni MSI. So ang kinagano dito guys, yung pump niya is naka-integrate into the radiator, eliminating it away from the primary heat source, yun yung sa CPU, so that it can help increase the pump's life, along with a durable 3-phase pump motor. So meron din siyang split pathway on the radiator, which helps to achieve rapid heat dissipation, so that mas mapapalambing nito yung liquid na dumadaloy pabalik sa CPU block. And of course, evaporation-proof tubing siya. Well, actually, this is more than enough para makool yung CPU na gamit natin. Pero okay pa din, since the cooler your CPU is, presumably, mas maganda ang performance and reliability nito. Next is our motherboard, which is yung MSI B560M Pro VDH Wi-Fi. As it belongs to the Pro Series line ni MSI, it quite looks much simple than the other high-end MSI motherboards. However, feature pack pa rin naman ito and it looks good in monochrome scheme as well. It also has MSI's Core Boost and Audio Boost technology, 2.5 gigabit LAN and Intel Wi-Fi 6 onboard for better wireless connectivity, as well as PCIe Gen 4 support and DDR4 overclocking memory boost at up to 5066 MHz. Connectivity-wise, manabi din siyang USB ports. There's even VGA, HDMI, DisplayPort, and even PS2 as well. Ideal for using legacy or older devices na gumagamit ng mga ports na yon. So on the RAM or memory naman, we'll be using the HyperX Fury 8GB DDR4 2133 kit. Bali, dalawang 4GB stick, which will run on dual channel mode. So action, bakit 8GB lang? So sa totoo lang, okay pa rin naman yung 8GB memory sa ngayon, 2021, lalo na kung di ka heavy multitasker, editor or power user. And kung ang mga ginagawa mo lang madalas sa PC mo ay web browsing or casual gaming, 8GB is actually enough for now, lalo na sa mga esports titles such as CSGO, Dota, Valorant at iba pa. We can easily upgrade to 16GB in the future if budget permits, since meron pang additional 2 slots na bakante yung motherboard natin. For the graphics card naman, we have the MSI GeForce GTX 1660 Super Gaming X. It features twin Frozor thermal design. Later guys, makikita nyo yung thermals nito sa benchmark. Tapos meron siyang dual fan, dalawang slot design card with 6GB of GDDR6 VRAM, as well as boost clock speed of up to 1815 MHz. There's also MSI's Torx Fan 3.0 design, which promises better cooling performance, as well as tatlong DisplayPort 1.4a and isang HDMI 2.0b outputs. Maganda yung card design, especially with its housing and backplate. Sa storage naman, we have the T-Force Delta sRGB 250GB SATA SSD. Ito yung SSD na may RGB yung cover and has a read and write speed rating of around 560MB per second. Oo, medyo malit na ito, especially if you plan to store your game library on your drive. So my recommendation is to also buy a separate hard drive like 1TB or 2TB para doon. So although wala akong sinaman hard drive dito sa build natin. Pwede ka rin naman kumuha ng mas malaking variant nito, like yung 500GB or even 1TB version if you don't plan to buy a hard drive. Although, may kamahalan nga lang. Next is yung power supply natin, and we have here yung bagong product ni MSI, which is yung MAG A550BN, which is yung 550W 80 Plus Pro Certified power supply, which translate to higher efficiency and lower energy consumption. Meron din itong DC to DC circuit design and 12 volts single rail, which helps with power stability, active PFC, as well as 12mm low noise fan and 5-year limited warranty for peace of mind. Actually, maganda yung design nito, lalo na may Dragon logo dito sa may exhaust, kaso panatakpa siya pag nilagay nyo. Ayan. So, meron din itong mga black sleeve cables para stealthy tingnan, hindi nyo makikita yung ketchup and mustard. Ayan. And lastly is our case, which is yung MAG Vampiric 100R ng MSI. It is an ATX case and meron itong half mesh, half closed front panel, which allows the case to have more airflow, with light strip across the front panel, which adds to the striking design factor ng case. Tempered glass is also on the side panel and may magnetic dust filters din sa top. Medyo malaki din yung clearance nito, giving you more flexibility on your fan or Predator mounting. Front I/O panel is also good with a lot of options including split mic in and out, although wala siyang USB Type-C. Let's fire this up and check natin yung benchmark. Ooh, ganda! Nice. Maganda talaga tingnan pag meron kang all-in-one liquid cooling. So yan. And also, maganda yung design talaga ni MSI dito sa may yung CPU block niya, yung naro-rotate yun. Yeah. So, nakita nyo, naka-front mounting siya kasi hindi siya kasha sa taas. So, yun na lang yung option dun sa harap. So, yeah. Guys, let's start the benchmark para nakita nyo yung thermals nito and yung performance ng ganitong build ng all MSI. Nga pala guys, this is 8GB. Makikita nyo yung performance nito dun sa mga game na Tinesco. 8GB ha, check nyo yung 8GB lang, okay? So yeah, let's start the benchmark. This video is sponsored by scdkey.com. scdkey.com is a marketplace website where you can purchase game keys and software keys with no hassle. scdkey.com offers a legit Windows 10 Pro key for only $17. This is the same keys I use on my PC builds. But to make it more awesome, they will be giving another 12% discount. Just type our coupon code XTNC to get it for only $15. You now have your legit Windows 10 key license all set, but in a more affordable price. If you're in the Philippines, purchasing is very easy. You can use PayPal, Paymaya, or GCash. Visit scdkey.com now. I'll put the link in the video description below. So thank you, scdkey.com, for sponsoring this video. Yun. So as we saw on the benchmarks, okay din itong naging configuration natin featuring all MSI components except dun sa CPU, memory, and storage, which doesn't have any MSI equivalent so far. Now, for the build itself, it looks good, especially due to the fact na naka-AIO tayo, which is yung MagCore Liquid 280R. Performance-wise, sakto lang naman when it comes to 1080p gaming, especially since we are running with 8GB RAM only. Pero like I said, there's an option for upgrade naman in the future, or maybe change or downgrade some of the components in order to save money. Guys, tip ko lang kung for example naman bibili kayo ng gitong specification like yung ginawa ko ngayon, kung gusto niyo pa makakuha ng FPS, ng mas mataas na FPS, is set nyo sa display settings, medium to high lang. Ito kasi yung ginawa ko is ultra. Lahat ng nakita nyo sa benchmark, ultra settings po yun. Isa pa, kung gusto nyo makaless pa dito, talagang super tight na yung budget nyo, nasa around 55,000. So, huwag nyo na kunin yung AIO. Mag-stock cooler na lang kayo ni Intel. Okay pa naman yun. Kung gusto nyo pa makaless, get the lower model. Yun yung Core i5 10400 or yung 11400. And kunin nyo din yung F. Pag walang F, ibig sabihin, meron po siyang built-in graphics pag walang F. Pag may F, yun po yung walang built-in graphics. So kunin nyo na yung may F sa dulo. 11400F. 10400F, yun. So, mas makakaless pa kayo doon. Okay? Tapos, ang total po nito is, yun nga, exact niya is 63,000 pesos. Mga nandun doon, 62,900 natin yung total ko dito. Kasi ang target talaga namin dito, guys, is 60,000 pesos. Okay, yung 60,000 gaming. Kasi, di ba, alam naman natin, guys, yung GPU umaabot po ng, ano ngayon, yung, ano to, GTX 1660 Super. Umaabot po siya ng 30,000 ngayon. So, this is a gaming X model. Siguro nasa around 29,000 po ito. Doon na lang kayo magbabawas ng price doon sa ibang components para makaless pa kayo. Tapos sa memory naman, ito. Yun nga, ginawa ko siyang 8GB kasi nga, yun nga, target namin 60,000. Gawin nyo, kung yan, kung kaya naman 65, kaya naman yun. 16GB, tapos yung AIO na siya, naka-AIO na. Ito, complete. 16GB plus may AIO ka na, that's 65,000 pesos kasi ang additional 4GB is around nasa 2,300 lang ata. Or 16GB is around nasa 5.7, mga ganyan, 5.5, may 4.7, 4.8. Depende po sa model. So, yun na lang yung gawin nyo. Pagka yung mga nagtitipid talaga, kulang sa budget or tight sa budget, yung kaninang sinabi ko. Ayan, kung gusto nyo pa maglagay ng additional fan or RGB lighting, pwede pa po sa top. You can add, pero actually ang ganda ng performance ng 280 na AIO yung sa fan included kasi hindi ganun kaingay. Yun ang maganda pagka malaki yung fan mo, that's 280mm, 140mm na dalawa, hindi siya ganun kaingay versus dun sa 120mm. Yun, so guys, there you have it. Huge shoutout muna kay MSI for sponsoring this video. Ayan, sila po nag-provide ng mga components dito. So, there you have it. Thank you guys for tuning in. Ako nga pala si Action. So, like the video, subscribe, and I'll see you on my next video.